Coming back to Sister Wardina, is there such thing as love before marriage? I mean, like, let's say I fall in love with some woman, and then some I'm allowed. Sorry. Okay. With a woman before marriage, is that allowed? And then, which one's better, before marriage or after marriage?
You know, God, I've been a teenager. Your hormones are all raging. You're very in rage. You know, you think about things that you're not supposed to think about. No? Let's be honest. And to the men, if you read in Surah An-Nur ayat 31-32, pasal hijab, okay? You understand that it is the eyes, yeah. But tadi kalau kita tengok dalam study tadi tu, dia bermula daripada mata. Now, dalam surah An-Nur tu, hijab untuk orang lelaki adalah apa? Pertama sekali, Allah kata, hijabkan diri orang lelaki dulu ni. Bukan untuk kita dulu, orang perempuan. It's for the man first. Jaga mata. Jaga mata, jaga kemaluan. You know, there are so many men who watch porn. You know, lepas tu, you know, there are so many women who say, Kota Ordina, it's all there. It's all in the internet, kan? Lepas tu, daripada kahwin dia tahu, husband dia tertarik pornografi. Pada adik-adik lelaki yang kena sayangi. If you know yourself, you know your friends are watching pornography, stop it right instantly. It is a disease. Yang merosakkan diri anda, mata. Mata ni, kan memang kena jaga sangat. Lepas tu, it degrades women. So sometimes, you know, because of all this freedom that we have, benda-benda bisik ni kena jaga dulu. Pertama sekali mata tu. Perempuan pun sama juga. Orang kata jaga mata, jaga kemaluan, lepas tu baru pakai hijab. So these are the first two things that you have to do first. Jaga mata tu dulu. Kadang-kadang rasa cinta-cinta ni, like the study tu, dia tunjuk, it all starts with communication. Once you start with communication, I think macam suka, there's somebody there for you, you know, to talk, to understand you, obviously. Who says you cannot love before marriage? It does happen. You akan suka orang. You know, it's a natural feeling. You cannot say no to that. But then again, like Kak Nina tulis tu, let's be rational, yeah? In our love, let's be realistic, okay? Let's throw away all this fairy tale love lah into the bin, okay? Apa ni, slap yourself. Get back up to reality. Macam tu lah, bila dah seronok sangat tu, let's just stand up and get back to reality. Alright? Ask yourself first, why do you love the person? Kenapa aku suka dekat dia? What? Is it physical attraction? What is it? Is it looks lah, looks, physical attraction? Is it his popularity? Yeah? Is it dia ni kaya ke? Suka dia ni ke? Kan? Kalau yang lelaki tu, kenapa suka perempuan tu? Dia cantik ke? Apa sebab-sebab lain? Why do you like that person? And who says is, you know, you can't stop this feeling of liking somebody. But let's get back up to reality, because when you talk to yourself, you rationalize, inshallah, you'll be okay. There are so many ayats in the Quran that tells us to beware. Beware of whispers of syaitan, beware of our nafsu, guard against your nafsu. InsyaAllah kemenangan akan berada kepada orang-orang yang berkata tidak kepada yang boleh menolak ataupun hawa nafsu dia ni. Jannah adalah bagi mereka. So insyaAllah, I'll try and read that ayat again. Okay, anyway, let me just read this quote. Love is the ultimate test of our worthiness as human beings. Understand your own love to know what love is. Professor Saul Gordon said, when you are in love, to you, the whole world revolves around this person whom you love. Marriage comes to prove the opposite and destroys all your perceptions. This is because you discover that the other world that you have, the other world that you have not been aware of. It is not the world of the human being, but it's the world of concepts, values, and habits, which is attitudes. Okay, after you get married, you will understand the attitude of the other person, which you paid no attention to before. You know, after you get married, it's about responsibilities. It's no longer about feeling of romantic. You know, yeah, you can be romantic at times, but honestly, you have no time to do that. It's about responsibility. It's about a bigger purpose. It's about, you know, finding money. It's about your kids falling sick. It's about giving your kids the best education. You don't even have time for each other sometimes, you know. It's very hard to make time. It is about responsibilities. It is about commitment. It is no longer about romanticness, about SMS lalu, I love. No, yes, you have that occasionally, but it's about a bigger purpose than that. When you are in love, you know what happens when you're in love? You tend to highlight all the good things about the other person, and then all the flaws tu memang you tak nampak. So that is what you do. During this is a study about stages of life done by Helen Fisher. Dia kata, ni barat, dia kata tiga stages of life. Lust, attraction and attachment. Dr. Donatella Maraziti daripada University of Pisa, dia kata serotonin levels of new lovers were equivalent to the low serotonin levels of OCD patients. They are blinded. You are magnifying the virtues of the other partner. You memang tak nampak dia punya salah tu, memang tak nampak, you can cover. Now that's a reality. That is what you do when you are in love. So this is a reality when you are in love. Memang tak nampak pada hakikatnya orang tu. So if you are realistic in your love, you understand that this person will have flaws. Are you able to live with that flaws? Apatah lagi kalau flaws tu jenis yang memang tak solat, merokok. Ya, Kak Dina, awal-awal Kak Dina dah pangkah ni. But in order to do that, you have to know what kind of man and woman that you are able to live with. I'll give you as an example. Dulu, before I started doing my solat, so I had boyfriend. Lepas ni, break up ni, ada lagi boyfriend lain. You know? It's just normal. Isn't it normal now? Coupling is just so normal. So I was that one though, once upon a time. Alhamdulillah, you know, Allah brought me back. I don't know, I think I would just be like my friend who is going to divorce now, yang masih duduk kat kelab malam, you know, because you know, Allah belum lagi mencapatkan hidayah ke dalam hati dia. Kesian dia dengan hidup dia. You know, they're still trying to find enjoyment, they're still trying to find happiness, konon-konon. You see, their lives are empty. They've got no purpose in their life. InsyaAllah, kat dia doakan one day, you know, Allah will give them the hidayah that Allah gave me. And Alhamdulillah, after that, obviously, when I embraced my deen again, my perspective of life completely changed. My perspective of men, my perspective of everything, basically, kan? So, bila Kak Dina dah mula solat balik, you know, so I doa kepada Allah. Masa tu, I was going out with a guy. But this guy did not solat. And bila kita ajak dia solat, dia kata, seluar kotor lah, apalah. Macam mana dia ni? Kan? I really liked him. I really liked him, you know. Yeah, he had money, he said he liked me. So, macam, okay lah, suka lah juga kat dia. Lepas tu, Kak Dina doa kepada Allah, kata, ya Allah, everything I said, ya Allah, jika dia baik, tu pun dekatkanlah. Jika dia tak baik, tu pun jauhkanlah. Allah knows what's best for me. So and then after that, I said, okay, what do I want in a man? Firstly, I said, this man must know how to converse in English. It's important to me, you know, because I speak in English. Bila bila kena marah ke apa, benda memang keluar bahasa Inggeris dulu. So I kena lah ada orang yang boleh bahasa Inggeris kan. It's my criteria, you have it. It's a criteria, this is a criteria. So jadi ni kena educated. Kalau boleh, dia kena study overseas. Beli di UK sebab I wish the shit that UK tak sepayan. Boleh lah, kahwin next best thing, kahwin orang beli UK pun okey lah. So that is my, that's my thing, okay. But obviously he has to pray, that is without a doubt. That is memang nombor satu, orang tu kena solat. So lagi kat Mina, kalau orang tu tak boleh nak bersolat, what does it mean? If you don't solat, it's you are arrogant. You are arrogant to the one who created you. You are not putting down your head to Allah who created you. You are not submitting and you do not understand your purpose of life. Your purpose of life is to worship Allah. If you don't worship Allah, if you don't love Allah, how in the world are you going to love me? So without a doubt, a man who doesn't pray is definitely out of my list. And a man who smokes, I don't like people who smoke. Aku takkan jenjam, oh yeah, I don't need to you, I mean you, that might be you. You know what I mean? So I get really irritated. But some men, they do stop. anak dia sampai dia bronchitis lah, sebab obat dia rumput depan isteri yang mengandung dengan anak-anak, tak kisah. So semoga tu ni is definitely, you know, that is many, you know. So try and stop, guys, you know, if you smoke, it's not cool, it's bad for you anyway. And Fatwa says it's, you know, it's haram anyway. So those are my criteria. So when Abang Ikwan came along, he gave me an email. And then I was looking, masa itu memang kat dia tengah mencari seorang. So usually when you are looking, Allah will give it to you. Masa itu rasanya I was ready and I was looking, so Allah gave it. Allah hantarkan nama itu ini. So balas email dia dalam satu bulan tu, cicak-cicak-cicak, tak kira like, so I can talk to him. Tapi obviously everything was very superficial, everything was good, kan? But it's okay, memang it's like that. So after that, I met him after 1 month of emailing, sharing ideas and thoughts. I'm not gonna see him anyway. Lepas tu dia kata nak jumpa. Kata okay fine, jumpa. Kata dia dah confirm yang dia ni memang orang, bukan stalker ke apa. So lepas tu dia datang rumah, dia kata, if you want to see me, you have to come to my house to meet my parents. I think that is the most appropriate way to see a woman. I should respect her. And obviously, another rule for me is, you know, I said this many times, I'm going to say it again, the man who loves you will not touch you before marriage. That is a very, very important rule. That means he respects you as a woman. He does not touch you before marriage. He loves you so much that he protects your dignity and pride. But unfortunately, what are we having now? Kita disuguhkan dengan media yang menggambarkan seolah cinta itu adalah, you know, have zina sebelum kahwin. You touch your hands, you tunjuk cinta, that is how you show love. So we think, you know, anak-anak Melayu kita ni semua fikir yang, oh, macam tu lah, kita cinta dengan tangan. No, a man who loves you will not do that to you. He respects you so much. He wants to be the wife, you know, he will not touch you. So Abang Iman, you know, even try to touch me, obviously. Alhamdulillah. So this is the guy I thought comfortable with him. You know what's the most important thing? Masa tu ramai sangat. Maksudnya, dia ramai tudung. Lepas tu, ada tajri-tajri lah, tak kahwin. Lepas tu, dia ada jumpa yang kat sini lah. Dia kata, isteri nombor 2 lah. Lepas tu, you know, macam, okay. I know Abang Iman didn't come from a well-to-do family. But what did I say? I saw him because he was smart. He was a smart man. And I knew that I wanted to marry a smart man. So lelaki-lelaki tu lah situasi sikit ke? Kalau kita punya girlfriend tu kan? Dia kawan tu, si dia tu lebih tinggi sikit orang kita. Kita smart lah. Man to be must be smart. Dia juga ni. So lepas tu, I didn't mind. I said I'm going through thick and thin with this man. I do not care that he did not have any money. I'm going through bawah benda lepas saya minta kahwin. Saya ni memang kata tak ada duit langsung. I mean, tell you the truth and honestly, lepas tu kata dah berhenti kerja. Abang Iqbal was working with somebody. We did not have money. I did not have enough money. We had just cents to pay for my car. Tak ada kena tarik lah sebab. I went through tears with him. Memang susah saya. I went through that with him. I'm proud that I went through that. I could have chosen an easy life. But no, I did not want that because that is not my destination. That is not what I wanted in life. I did not want to marry a rich man because I wanted to go through this pain with a person to make me a better person. If I, cuba ya kan, kalau kita nak kahwin lah dengan Tan Sri Kaya Raya sekarang ni, kenapa kita nak tak pelvi sekarang ni? I will be sitting here with you guys and sharing my experiences. You know, why should I do that? My life is too comfortable already. So really, look back at yourself. And I told Abang Iqbal, I told him, if you want to love me, let me read this hadith to you. Now, what did it say? Ibn Majah said, there is nothing better for those who love other than marriage. So that is your destination. Marriage has to be your destination. You don't just suka-suka go out. I don't know, don't just take couple je, tak ada arah tujuan. You know, there's so many, I hear all the statements macam, kita berkawan dulu, kita tak tahu lagi, belum lagi, you know, merancangkan. No, what else you have? Berkawan tu, that means it should always be, your destination should always be marriage. And there's nothing better for people who love the other than marriage. So my destination with him was obviously marriage. We got married. Alhamdulillah, rasa tenang hati tu, kahwin dan kita hidup memang susah, senang bersama. So ask yourself, what is important to you? what do you want? So I told him, well, you do not love me other than our love. Niat kita kahwin tu apa? Kita sebelum kahwin tu dah pegang, dah berpeluk, dah ber SMS, macam-macam. Hang on, you know, restrain yourself. You know, not too much. Not too much. Like, sometimes it's very easy to justify, like, what I find is to justify, you know, nak ke sikit je, nak ke keluar dulu. Bila kita dah buat tu, istighfar, minta ampun, minta taubat kepada Allah, you know, kita orang perempuan ni, let's have a bit more pride and dignity in ourselves. Cuma mahal tak tu, dia kita cakap. It's okay. Biar lagi susah, dia dapat kita lagi, you know, sebenarnya. Like, you know, masa tu sebenarnya suka kat perempuan tu, tapi tak boleh lah tunjuk sangat. I like it. I like it, he's a simple man, he's smart, you know. Apa ni, he prays, I like him. But I didn't just show it, of course, macam ni, aku nak kahwin cepat, tapi macam kena lah control sikit. So, you know, I think that is very true. You do not let go everything before you get married. And I told him, if you want to marry me, please, betulkan niat kita, because I want to improve myself to become a better Muslim. Nothing else than that. Niat saya berkahwin dengan Abang Ikhwan, Rina cakap dengan Abang Ikhwan, kahwin dengan saya kerana Allah. So when you have problems in your marriage, apa pun terjadi, you come back to our niat again. Cakap dengan dia, kadang-kadang dia tahu gaduh. Memang kita akan bergaduh. There are times that you feel like, why did I marry this man? Sometimes I'm sure he feels like, yee, dah pula nak marry ni. Tapi, I think you go back into saya, kita kahwin, niat kita kahwin, kita kahwin itu kerana Allah. We wanted to become better Muslims and we are going to go through that journey together, inshallah. That, to me, will save you. And if you look at the situation now, there's the high rate of divorce among Muslims is very, very alarming. Let me read to you one study that shows how, if we study the marriage before, love before marriage, okay. In Cairo University, they did a study on love marriages and traditional marriages. So 80% of marriages which takes place after a love affair ended with failure. So success rate is not more than 12%. But traditional marriages, which means marriage after, love after marriage, success rate was 70%. So love, desires, passion is not a guarantee for a successful marriage. Yeah. What is a guarantee for a successful marriage? Remember, your destination is definitely marriage. So what makes a successful marriage? What is it? Is it passion, sex? Is it desires? Is that it? No. To me, the most important thing is you have to make sure that you and the other person are compatible in terms of thinking, in terms of planning of your future. You have to be compatible in that. You are heading in the same direction. So, if this guy wants to go there and you want to go this way, it's not going to work out. So let's just double check. And that is where you have to know the person. To me, it does matter. You have to know the person. You have to know a person. You have to know their background. You have to know where they're heading to. InsyaAllah, kalau you tahu orang tu memang orang yang baik, orang yang soleh, orang yang bijak daripada para lelaki, cari wanita yang mampu menguruskan rumah tangga yang baik. Sebab kita nak menanam benih kita ini ke dalam rahim-rahim wanita-wanita yang baik. Sebab itulah yang akan melahirkan zuriat-zuriat yang baik. Allah dah bagikan, kita dah tahu kan, tengok harta, tengok rupa, tengok keturunan. Yang paling baik tu, agama kan, you've heard this over and over and over again. And yes, you cannot go wrong if you choose that. But remember, compatibility in thinking. When you can carry a conversation with the other person, you are comfortable when you talk to other person, you can share ideas. Ini tidak, you jumpa orang tu tak tahu dah cakap apa, apa benda tu. You know, how can you like a person when you can't even carry a conversation with them, you know? So, Wallahualam, insyaAllah that will get you thinking again.
Jazakallah khairan kathirun khairan sir, which I think is very, very comprehensive in a way, and like putting things into practical. I truly respect the sacrifices made by both Mama Ifan and also Kawardina.
You guys are going to make sacrifices too. You ask any marriage, you know, they're all going to make sacrifices.
I don't understand about that, but then, I mean, sharing it with us, I mean,
If you ask Anwar's parents right now, they've got like a banyak cerita to share, you know what I mean? So seriously, you're all going to have these struggles in your life. What makes people get divorced now to now say, why? Why?
Because... I want to give you an extra question to ask. Because just now you mentioned previous question, I mean, previous answer, you said love is, some might define it as intense feeling of affection.
Yeah.
But then, going through marriage, I mean, you have roller coasters, right? Macam tadi cakap, ada time tu macam
mungkin... Before marriage, it's tanggungjawab.
Ah, tanggungjawab, yes.
Mula-mula tu, yang tak ada rejection terlepas. After marriage, it's really about responsibility.
Tapi how you can, you know, keep hold to that? I mean, like, mungkin sometimes bila kita argue dah was kan, macam dia berlintir kan.
Yeah, I think that you
want
to ask
Abaikwan
how he stands.
Yes, yes. I mean, how to endure that? I mean, like, macam how to keep in love, you know? Macam, kadang-kadang tu bila kita going through the marriage, kadang-kadang perasaan affection tu macam
dah sakit. Gimana, you tahu?
So macam ni kita nak, you know, hold on to the, you know, the marriage.
But then yeah, why did you get married in the first place? If you get married the person because of their looks, if you get married the person because of what, wealth, that is what's going to hang you on, the wealth and the looks and the popularity and the status. So if your niat, inshallah, I believe this completely. That if your niat is kerana Allah will protect you. And whatever happens, you go back to that niat.
And therefore, it's the ultimate love and definition of love, you may say.
It's your intention, Esmeralda. It's your intention. What you are having this relationship with this person for, with,
Allah. So, Allah, kesan betul dengan jawapan-jawapan Kak Ordina macam, tadi soalan terdiam kan? Tuan-tuan, apa-apa. And that's basically for our first session. And we will